And as Abu Dhabi ports, we feel a great responsibility in protecting the marine environment.
There were a few challenges that were faced by the GHD dive team, one of which was the time permitted to undertake the works was quite short due to the deadline for completing the works before construction occurred at the Khalifa port. This gave us a two-week window to move all the 500 corals, and using hammer and chisel in close proximity to live organisms such as sea urchins, which can pose a threat if they sting you.
It was a collaborative effort, and the methodology was created in partnership with Professor John Burt and the Environment Agency, Abu Dhabi.
Corals here in Abu Dhabi are specifically unique because they have a high tolerance of high temperature and high salinity.
GHD used a hammer and chisel to knock off the corals from the northern revetment. Once the coral is removed, it is taken to a basket, which is then placed at the seabed with a lot of other corals that have been removed from the revetment. Once we have filled all of these baskets up with live corals, they are transported to the vessel as quickly as possible and maintained wet through dousing with water and covering in damp towels. The vessels were then moved from the northern revetment over to the recipient site, which is on the environmental breakwater, the Rasconada side. Once the vessels with the corals on board reached the recipient site, the boats anchored and immediately the corals were placed from the boat down to the seabed to immerse them in water. At the breakwater, individual sections of the revetment stabbits or rocks were cleaned using wire brushes to remove the biofilm. Then hammer and chisel again were used to knock divots out of the structures, either the concrete stabbits or the rock itself. An adhesive was applied to these divots. The corals were then placed onto the adhesive and set.
We're exploring what depths is more successful. What method of attaching the coral is more successful, cement or e-proxy? We're going to monitor the results from now for a three-year period, and the results will inform a research paper which can be used to inform future efforts.
I am sure by the end of this project, and through constant monitoring of the coral's growth and coping after the location, we will have a better and deeper understanding of what should and should not be done.